From time to time, I ask myself, is it possible to miss something you've never known? Let me rephrase. Is it possible to be homesick for a place you have never been? My son, I was born on Earth, but I think I have been homesick for Europa my whole life. I'm writing this from the island. The view from up here is like nothing else I've seen. By the time you read this, I'll be gone, and the world will look very different from how it does now. But the island should still be there. They built this thing to last. Come to the island if you ever get lonely. Come here and think of me. Come to the island if you ever get lonely. Come here and think of me. My son, from time to time, I ask myself, is it possible to miss something you've never known? Let me rephrase. Is it possible to be homesick for a place you've never been? I was born on Earth, but I think I have been homesick for Europa my whole life. I'm writing this from the island. The view from up here is like nothing else I've seen. By the time you read this, I'll be gone, and the world will look very different than how it does now. But the island should still be there. They built this thing to last. Come to the island if you ever get lonely. Come here and think of me. My son. It has surpassed my expectations in every way, this place. I don't know what I expected. They've given me a few days to adjust, but I can't make my mind believe that this is real. The air tastes like water, and the water tastes like wine. The gardeners have turned this place into a paradise. Thank you. The sins of the past can stay home on Earth. Things will be different this time. They have to be. It breaks my heart that you'll never see our homeworld, but I can't say I regret bringing you here. You're going to have everything I couldn't have. Clean water, fresh air, wide open skies. Everything a child deserves. That's what I want for you. And you'll have community too. Human beings to play with and learn from and grow alongside. Every person here has a different story. But our futures are bound up together now. Don't be scared. I know they're going to love you.
Thank you.
Some say that humans brought life to Europa. If you ask me, all we did was unlock the life that was sleeping within. Why have so many terraforming projects failed where this one succeeded? It can only be that Europa holds some innate capacity for life. Look at the gardeners. They came to this moon as mere tools to prepare for our arrival. But through 1,000 years, they've evolved into a whole ecosystem mimicking the biodiversity of old Earth. I can't wait to learn more about these creatures, to live among them. They're our family now. Thank you. I know you have a lot of questions, most of which can't be answered in this notebook. There's a chance you're angry, or that you'll get angry one day when you're older. Europa is unbelievable, but it's not finished. We're trying to build something better than what we left behind. That will take time. Generations, even. That is why I'm sending you ahead.
Thank you.
The greatest pleasure in my life is watching you watch the world. New faces, passing ships, whatever new sight catches your attention. You drink everything in like you're hungry for it. You also spend a lot of time putting things in your mouth which are not food. Another kind of intellectual curiosity, I suppose. As I'm writing this, most of the human race are still asleep on the island. In a few years' time, you're going to join them. I'll stay back here and work, so that when you wake up, you'll wake up somewhere better. I don't know exactly what the world will look like. All I know is that people on the homeworld made the mistake of not thinking past tomorrow by sending you ahead. I'm staking my heart on the future. There's so much I want to tell you, so much to teach. But at the same time, I don't want to smother your innate desire to learn things yourself. Civilizations collapse when we stop letting children ask questions. If Europa is going to survive, we'll need to raise a generation who are not just curiously determined, but determinedly curious. I hope you can grow up that way, my son. Going to have everything I couldn't have. Clean water, fresh air, wide open skies. Everything a child deserves. That's what I want for you. The greatest pleasure in my life is watching you watch the world.
There's so much I want to tell you.
So much to teach. I have made it my task to catalog as many gardener species as I can. There are bipedal gardener bugs, small enough even you can grab them with those tiny hands. Quite a contrast with their wind-breathing cousins, some of which are as big as buildings. At night, I can hear them lowing overhead. To think all this variety evolved from a single generation of Terraformer AI. Yesterday, there was a near miss. One of the Leviathans nearly collided with a ship. We have to be careful how we behave with the gardeners. They have been here far longer than we have and are more in tune with the planet's rhythms. If we don't learn from them, I fear we will be in for a struggle. There's been more trouble from the incident yesterday. The captain of the ship is furious, though from what I saw, the accident was his fault. He said the creature ought to be dismantled for our safety. There were arguments for a while, but in the end, the captain's side won out. The Leviathan has been caught and taken apart. I tried my best, but they wouldn't listen. This is supposedly the safe thing to do. What's the harm of turning off faulty machinery? The sound it made as they pulled it to the ground, it did not sound very machine-like to me. Thank you. There's been another incident. A serious one this time, down at the mines. A herd of gardeners charged through the valley just as the day's shift was ending, and they collided with the crowd. We did what we could, but some people didn't make it. The most distressing thing is we can't identify what caused the stampede. It came at the worst possible moment, almost like an attack. Could the gardeners be turning hostile? I pray it's not so. Aside from the stampede, there have been smaller issues with the gardeners. For example, the pollinator bites. Nothing deadly, a mere annoyance. They nip on the arm and fly away. But there are parts of the colony where the pollinators do not bite at all. In fact, they don't even have teeth. The attacks are concentrated in areas of maximum disruption, at the logging camps and mines and resource extraction sites. The greater the disruption, the more frequently the bites occur. Deep in the gardener's coding is a directive to resist anything that could make the planet unlivable. Our actions must be triggering this resistance. They are trying to protect us from ourselves. I must write very carefully tonight, because you're tossing against my knee. This is the first moment of peace I've had all day. They warned me that 3 would be a lively age. I still wasn't prepared for just how lively. It seemed like only yesterday you were learning to wriggle across the ground. Now if I don't keep hold of you, you'll sprint out of my workshop and into the meadows. You love playing with the gardeners, large or small. They don't seem to frighten you one bit.
Thank you.
must submit ourselves to change. It is the only constant in life. Change is what permits life. It is life itself. If you can worship change, you will find nothing else to fear. This is why you must enter the cryo-freeze chambers on the island. But I'll hold on to you for another year, my son. I can't bear to let you go to the future. Not quite yet. A fine day today. The air has the clarity of early winter, and I have a view right down the valley. I only wish I was riding with better news. There's been a long stretch of peace, but I'm afraid this idiotic conflict has sprung up again. As we fight the gardeners, we teach them to fight. They are evolving their own weaponry. Detonators and heat-seeking rays, mirroring us, outgrowing us, twisting the land into a fortress. violence we have inflicted on the planet is returning to us tenfold. It is the same story as what happened on the homeworld, only here it is occurring at a terrifying pace. Thank you.